What's happening, ladies and gentlemen? This is Min from Architecture Inspirations. Today I'm going to show you some tips and tricks for the newest features in Vray Next for SketchUp. Let's get started. After you have installed Vray Next for SketchUp, you can see that the toolbars look very similar to the previous version, except that there's a new button on the main toolbar. This is for cloud batch rendering. And more importantly, there is a completely new toolbar, which I will go over later. Now, let's start with the asset editor. At first glance, you can see that the asset editor has two new icons. One is for render elements, and the other one is for textures. These features existed in the previous versions. Now, it's just a lot easier to access them. Like before, you can left-click each category to switch to that tab. But now, you can right-click to add new assets in that category. This works for all of the categories. When adding new assets, you can hold that control to keep that window open so you can add multiple assets at once. Also, you can control and left-click multiple categories to open them all at the same time. If you want to close a category while keeping the others open, then use control and left-click to close that specific one. Next, if you click on this arrow on the left side, then you will open the asset library. Here you will see the materials library, which is similar to the previous version. What's new is the Create section, which includes all types of assets that you can create. These types of assets are the same as the ones over here. And also available down here. This library just makes it easier to see each asset because you can adjust the previews using these three buttons here. The library interface can also be switched between two main layout presets, vertical or horizontal. Another cool thing about the new library is now you can see all of the assets or materials at once, so you can easily search for what you need. You can add an asset to the scene by right-clicking, Add to Scene, or Apply to Selection. Alternatively, you can simply drag an asset from the library into your list of assets. You can also hold down Shift or Control and left-click to select multiple assets and add them to the library together. This works for deleting multiple assets as well. My favorite thing about the library is that you can add custom folder locations. This makes it super easy to add your personal collection to expand your library. Now if you click on this arrow, it will open up the right fly-off panel, which will show you more parameters for Vray assets. First, you will see an improved preview swatch that works great for assets such as lights and textures. For other assets, such as render elements, this window will show a preview image and a short description to help explain it. Some of the new assets include new render elements, such as material ID number, multi-matte materials, and lighting analysis. There's also a new metallic material, which makes it possible to use PBR materials that has metalness textures, such as the ones found on Polygon. There are also two new color correction curves that help you adjust textures without having to use other programs such as Photoshop. Another awesome feature is that assets from all types can now be saved as VRMAT files, so you can load them in other projects. For example, here I have a dome light in the model. I can right-click and save it as a VRMAT file. I'm going to place it in my custom library folder. Now, if I right-click that folder in the library and click refresh, I can now see that the new asset has been added to my custom folder. A faster way to save the asset is to simply drag it in the folder on the left side here. If you want to make changes to an asset, you can update it and save it again, and it will prompt a window to replace the existing asset. This is a very powerful feature that helps you organize and reuse existing assets, which saves a lot of time. Finally, let's talk about the new toolbar. The first one is to enable and disable solid widgets. This will determine whether Vray objects, such as rectangle and sphere lights, will appear as solid objects or just line shapes. The second one is to hide Vray widgets, which hides all Vray objects from the viewport. This will allow you to export a clean screenshot of your model. As you can see, hiding these widgets will not affect the render result. The next section includes tools for materials and textures. The first one is to remove material from a selected face, group, or component. And the next four are Vray UV tools, which helps you map the texture on an object with one click. Finally, the last tool is the Scene Interaction tool, which helps explore materials hierarchy in the scene. or you can use it to adjust lighting intensity by dragging up or down. These are just some of the new features. There are also other features such as auto exposure and auto white balance as seen in KS Group official release video. You can check it out for more details. And there we go. Those are some tips and tricks for the newest features in Vray Next for SketchUp. I will definitely create more videos to go into details in each of these topics. That's all for today, guys. Leave a like if you enjoyed the video. Comment below and tell me which one is your favorite feature. Stay inspired, guys, and I'll see you next time.